hear someone at the door. Go and check it out, okay? I mean, you hear all those other dogs barking, right? Don't you? Do you even want to try it? Like once or twice?
Pardon me for pointing out that this contradicts everything you've told me about the situation. Hold on a second.
Hi.
Hi.
Come in.
Tilda? Oh, it's gonna be okay. I know, but... it's Friday night, and we can take care of this on Monday. Okay, bye. Patient.
Leonard, this is Bruce Banner.
Leonard Sampson.
Hi.
You two need to get dry. There are shirts up in my closet. I'm cooking, you're talking. Now go.
Those months were kind of a blur. I tried to keep moving, and when I got to the monastery, I finally had some time to try to figure out what had happened.
And they just let you stay?
I'm good at fixing things. I mean, even monks like their toilets to work. It was peaceful, and for a while that was all I wanted. Then I started to hear them talking about a guy in the town, a rug dealer. He had a satellite link, and he was checking prices in New York, and I tried to resist it, but my brain started going, asking questions, and finally I had to try, and I got on, and eventually that got me to Mr. Blue and
Stearns and trimethadine.
When I read what he had been doing, I mean I didn't think it was possible to synthesize inhibitors that are that complex, but he's doing it by the bucket load.
His work is unbelievably brilliant. I mean, he is way out in front. He had some kind of an ethics cloud around him, but it didn't stop him.
I need to go and see him. Maybe he's got something, maybe he doesn't. It'll be a much longer shot without the data, but I really don't see that I have a choice.
What data?
Our data. That's why I came. I tried to get into the lab, but there was nothing. It was gone.
I got in there as soon as I could before they took it all away. Hoped somewhere that it might tell us something someday. What?
Sometimes, hope comes back so quickly. Does the general know that you have this?
No, I don't think so. I haven't spoken to him in a couple of years.
You have to be sure.
Bruce, I need to understand why it has to be like this. I don't understand why we can't just go in there together and talk to him. I mean, it's just pride with him, you know?
No, no, no. No, it's not. He wants to make it a weapon. When you were in the hospital, he told me what he wanted to do. He wants it out of me. He wants to dissect it so that he can replicate it. He was in Brazil. He was there. I saw him.
How?
I don't know. I have turned it around. I have looked at it from every angle, and it makes no sense to me. Unless it was Stearns. Would it be Stearns? Would he do something like that?
I mean, I hear he's a total anarchist, and I can't imagine him having any communication with him.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. I have to go and see him.
Well. Why didn't you wait for me?
I
think we're all set. This woman, on the very last day of my practice, right before I came out here, spends almost the entire session on her cell phone. It was kind of the last straw for me, and I finally, towards the end of the session, was like, excuse me, I don't mean to interrupt, but Miss So-and-so, I've been analyzing your condition for nearly 3 months now, and I think I can say conclusively that your issues are less manic depressive than they are caffeinated uncaffeinated. I still have no idea if she was talking to on the phone.
Maybe she just wanted a second opinion.
Yeah, that crossed my mind.
Oh my God. You grew it. I can't believe you actually grew it. I thought if anyone could do it, you could do it, but I really wasn't sure it could be done.
It shouldn't survive here. It took 4 months just to cultivate the bacteria for the soil. I've almost lost it a couple of times, but it's held on somehow, despite everything.
It's so beautiful.
Thank you so much for sending it to me.
Yeah. I just wanted you to know that I was...
I know.
I'm so...
Love she pours into this little guy. It's amazing he and I are still friends. Come on, let's go put his bed together.
You scared me.
Sorry.
Oh, yeah, I thought it might be easier for all of us. Want some wine?
Yeah, if you're having some.
Oh, I'm having a lot.
I didn't come here to see Betty, if that's what you're thinking.
Really? Why did you come?
I have a problem. I thought that part of the solution might be here.
Cryptic. But I'll take it at face value. I'll confess something to you if you clear up some things for me. First, I confess as a man, as Betty's lover, that I've always hoped you were dead. Not because I didn't like you, but because I love Betty. And I've known that unless you were really gone, or she believed you were, that there'd always be three of us in this relationship. I've dreaded the thought of you walking through the door. But now that you're here, I have to admit, I'm very happy about it. Because I'm also a psychiatrist. And I'm very committed to putting light into dark corners, so to speak. Betty has a very dark corner that I've never found my way into, despite considerable careful effort. And the only thing I know about her dark place is that you're in it. So why use something that she won't talk about?
There are aspects of my personality that I can't control. And when I lose control, it's very dangerous to be around me. I hurt Betty in a way that I will never forgive myself for.
You don't drop your career and fall off the face of the earth for 5 years because you have an anger management issue, Bruce. You see a shrink.
It's a little bit more complicated than that.
Trust me when I tell you, I've heard them all.
Not this one.
Completely honest and yet avoiding something at the heart of the matter. Exactly like her. Can't just call him a cab.
No, I don't want him calling him a cab.
You don't think he can take care of him?
The car seems to be dead. I must have left the lights on last night. Are you okay to walk?
We can't leave here together.
Well, I'll meet you somewhere. Remember our bench by the
library? Alright, let me go first.
There's a back way. I'll show you.
About what he was really trying to do.
We did talk about it. And we were all comfortable. Nobody thought something like that was possible.
Nature takes a long time to build us the way that we are. Delicate, wonderfully complicated systems refined over billions and billions of years, and nobody understood that better than you and me. And so we did what? We come in here with these big brains of ours, and we monkey with things, and we think that we're gonna do what? Improve it overnight? And then we act surprised when it blows up in our face in some way that we didn't expect.
What?
They're here. Betty, look at me. Look at
me.
You have to go far away from me as you can. Don't argue with me. Just go.
Go!
The academic language in the published reports is maybe
three dozen off our list, and I don't even have samples for three dozen more.
You keep seeing it in your mind, don't you?
Yes.
Did it shake you up? You're damn right it did. Shook me up.
It was outside my training. An enemy has an agenda, and we fight to block it. That, it had no agenda.
Major, a great writer once said, there are clefts in the rock where we see the back part of God and tremble. There's no training for what you saw out there, because it's not an enemy that confronts us. It's a new power let loose through a crack in the cliff of nature's mystery. And how many times do you think that's happened in all of human history? Fire, the splitting of the atom, the universe unveils a secret. And people recoil, cowering in fear and awe. And then comes the person who stops trembling, who steps forward to face the flame and seizes the burning stick and says, this will I master and use. And civilization's history is written by those men. Major, we've glimpsed the back part of God. And for our nation, and for our way of life, I intend to put a harness around it. And history will say that here, at this moment, we confronted our fear. You're a good soldier, Kathleen. If you want to go back up the rabbit hole, you go with nothing but my thanks.
I'd just be staring out the window, wondering who was screwing it up in my place.
Mysterious, this thing inside of you. All the other scars have healed.
No, that's mine. His scars heal, mine don't.
Yes, they do. They leave a mark, but they stop hurting. That pain didn't last. Not knowing was so much worse. I looked for your face everywhere. I never stopped.
Rumors continue to swirl about a violent clash between forces of the U.S. military and an unknown adversary on the campus of Culver University earlier today, but we know if the...
T.
I'm here.
Joint Chiefs 1, National Guard above.
Oh, God's sake. Joe, the National Guard can't deliver tents to hurricane zones on time.
You telling me I gotta liaise with part-timers?
It's domestic on paper, so Guard and FBI have to be involved.
FBI?
Did the Chiefs see the tapes? Do they think that was a video game?
Use them for intel and equipment, then tell them to back off.
It's a waste of time!
Now what about Blonsky?
He's not looking good, but he...
is everything you said he was. He was what made it happen.
And I saw the way he was moving before he got hit. Reminded me of something I think we'd both like to forget.
Are you asking me a question, Joe?
Make your list, and then get back to me.
It was so big, it was like this huge, like Hulk.
Yeah.
And homie was just stomping on everything.
McGee, who happens to be a reporter for the campus paper, captured this on his cell phone.
This green dude just like picked up the motor and hurled at these Humvees. Huge explosion.
Oh, it's like US Army Zero, Hulk One. Badass.
Sir, it's Blonsky.
Delta's in backup. If we make it before they move again, we'll have two tries. If we can't take him inside, we try for shot as he leaves. But if we can't hit him unaware before he makes a streak, then plainclothes will try to follow and we stand down. Under no circumstances is Banner to be engaged directly.
What about if he goes nuclear?
We'll fail to learn from our mistakes, won't we? He's never turned unless he was cornered or hurt. So if we can't take him out from long range, or if he makes us and he runs, then we fall back and we let him go. Any more questions?
So much of a rematch, is it?
There's 1.5 million people within a 3-mile radius. You want to take that thing out there?
Are you sure about your boy?
The dog in the hunt that won't run from the bear if it shows up. If we play this right, I'll never have to let him off the leash. Ready?
I've never seen anyone come around from a Tranquilos like that.
Why the hell aren't we keeping him under?
You want to be the one to stick a needle in his arm that he doesn't want? She's our best insurance. Keep her right next to him. He knows if he pops off, it's her that gets hurt.
Well, what do you want to do with Stearns?
I want him pinned in that lab with you. Don't let him out of the room to piss until he's identified every bottle, box, and machine in the place, then package it up and get it back home. Then get aiding and abetting charges and get him turned over to us. Banner won't give us answers, maybe we can get him to.
Forgive what you've done to him.
He's a fugitive. He made choices.
You made him a fugitive. To cover your failures and to protect your career. I know what you said to him after the accident. Before I woke up, what you proposed, That's why he ran away and gave up.
His work. His blood is the property of the United States Army, and my duty supersedes my personal feelings in this matter.
Freedom, democracy, our way of life.
Something like that.
We believe in so much. We have to start with truth or the rest of it doesn't work. Don't ever speak to me as your daughter again.
It's only because you're my daughter that you're not in handcuffs, too. God, are you all right?
I couldn't reach you and...
I'm okay. I'm not hurt. A lot of people were, though.
I know. It's been all over the TV. It doesn't seem real.
Well, it was real.
Come home.
Just come home.
Leonard? Did you call someone the night Bruce was at our house? Is that why they came for him?
I was frightened. Please forgive me.
I do. But I'm not coming home yet.
Where are you going?
I have no idea. But I'll let you know when I do. I promise. Goodbye, Leonard.
Betty?
Lá em Amazônia.
Ah, sim. Eu preciso. Eu pago.
Mas eu procuro para você, do okay. Jeito.
Ok. Obrigado.
Tchau.
All author's names deleted. He was using a randomizer to tap into the different wireless networks every time he went online. We can't even tell where the emails went or where they came from.
has to get rid of it.
Get rid of what?
It is chemistry. He wants to neutralize whatever powers the transformation.
That's not a good thing.
No, it's not a good thing, Major. But I don't want Ben or anything.
God damn it, I want what's inside of him!
We'll have the agency people keep their radar up.
What will that do? He's already on the moon!
Tell me that one more time.
Joe, do I look like I'm not being serious?
T, I've known you a long time, and I've never known a cooler head under fire. I know something bit you in the ass down there, but that is one hell of a white whale story, and I am way out on a limb with you on this already.
Ask Blonsky.
Ten feet tall. Put it at 1,500 pounds. Easily. And green. Or grey, sir. Greenish grey. It's very dark, I couldn't tell. Put three clips on it, didn't even flinch, and I didn't miss, stake my medals on it.
Now, is there a medal you haven't won, Captain?
Medal of Honor, sir, but a high percentage of those are awarded posthumously.
Of course. T, do you want to tell me what the hell you really think is going on here?
Banner's work was a tangent of biotech.
You told me you were going to Brazil to nab a scientist. Are you telling me another one of your super soldier experiments has gone haywire? Is there anything that came out of that program that didn't turn into a mess?
Joe, what we're talking about here is something that could be an incredibly dangerous weapon in the wrong hands, and we don't know what his intentions are.
Put together a new list. But be prepared to explain everything on it.
Let me emphasize that what I'm about to share with you is tremendously sensitive both to me personally and the Army. You're aware that we've got an infantry weapons development program. Well, in WW2, they initiated a sub-program for biotech force enhancement.
Yeah, super soldier.
Yes. An oversimplification, but yes. And I dusted it off. Got him doing serious work again, bold work. Across the hall, they're trying to arm you better. They were trying to make you better.
In all the obvious ways. And some not so obvious. Banner's work was very early phase. It wasn't even weapons application.
He thought they could strengthen cellular resistance to radiation. We thought it could give our boys built-in insulation against some of that depleted uranium no one likes talking about. It was promising, but politicians don't give a flying F about what real soldiers need. They like big twin-rotor heliplanes that don't work, that they can build in their state while perfectly good machinery rots under their nose. So our money was running out. Banner was so sure of what he was onto that he tested it on himself. I let him. It was supposed to be very low exposure. And something went very wrong. Or it went very right. I still don't know.
So why do you run?
Banner was brilliant, one in a generation, but there are people who grasp that peace and freedom derive from power. And people who don't. He doesn't. He's a scientist. He is not one of us.
So it'd be good to nail them then. Why don't you just take the data to someone else?
Because he is the data. He skipped before I could get him on a table and get it out of him.
far as I'm concerned, that man's whole body is property of the U.S. Army.
You said he wasn't working on weapons, right?
No.
But you were, weren't you? You were trying other things.
One serum we developed was very promising. But it didn't pan out. Or it did, but it was unstable. It made subjects unstable. We were refining it. Then Al-Hakid happened. All those pictures at the hearings. Congress lost its nerve and they killed it.
I have a real contempt for people like that.
You and me both, Captain. You and me both. Blonsky, how old are you? 45?
39.
You know, when I came back from Vietnam, I was 27. I looked 45. So you're beating the curve. It takes a toll, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
So we'll get out of the trenches. You should be a colonel by now with your record.
Nah, I'm a fighter. I'll be one for as long as I can. Yeah, if I could take what I know now, put it in the body I had 10 years ago, that would be someone I wouldn't want to fight.
I could probably arrange something like that.
You said they killed it.
They killed the program.
But you kept some of it, didn't you?
Did you ever hear about saving something for a rainy day? Well, I think it's raining.
Couple you're running it hot, that should be like 165, not 185.
Right. Pizza.
Put me on the sand. Awesome.
That's two large pepperoni and olive.
Thanks.
That's $29.50.
Oh, we have an account with Stanley. He knows us. Oh, we're Theta.
Yeah, I can see that. I'm gonna need to call Stan to check that out. Do you mind?
Yes, I mind. Not to mention, these pizzas, well, they took forever, and now they're cold. Oops. Sorry.
You know what? You don't want to make me angry. You're not gonna like me when I'm angry.
Oh. Pervert!
Dude. Where are your balls, man? You can't lay down for that shit. You gotta smash that door in and get what is... Tiffy!
Hey, man, those dicks in radiation ordered this and then skipped. You want it?
Oh my God, it's you.
Sorry, what?
I can't believe you actually came.
Do we know each other?
No. I was in terrible need. You heard my plea, and you came to help me.
No, I'm just
yes. No, listen, shh. You, my friend, are a hero. Don't hide from your power.
You mind if I get online for 1 second?
My kingdom is yours.
It's not even just the data. They made it look like the program never even existed. It's gone as if it never happened.
Well, they closed the whole building for a year after the explosion. Military guards.
I don't know what I was thinking. I thought maybe there'd be some kind of a scrap, but there is nothing here. It was stupid to even risk coming.
What do you do now?
I gotta move on.
Where?
Stan, it's better if I don't tell you. I'm gonna get my things and I'm gonna go tonight.
Oh, you're not gonna go anywhere. It's about to rain like hell. I'll close up. We'll have some food. We're pretty well closed here, folks. I'm sorry.
Oh, come on, Stan. It's Friday night.